first got into college, I had no clue what I wanted to do. I didn't know who I wanted to be. I was like, what am I going to go into? I originally wanted to go into business. And as a child, I was just reflecting on all the things that I did. None of those things I was naturally good at. But my name's Gabby, and I had the gift of gab. So I started up my own podcast just to focus on like women empowerment, spiritual enlightenment, and social injustice issues, things that were really close to my heart. And that kind of led me to realize like I have a passion for using my platform to help influence other girls that look like me. She was a big inspiration for me, Oprah. I studied Oprah. I told everybody, I'm the next Oprah. Y'all didn't know? I'm the next Oprah. I kept saying it over and over again and really speaking that life into that manifestation and speaking into that prayer. So for me, it's when I saw another Black woman, a woman, be able to use her platform and her voice to say, like, actually, we are going to talk about this, and we're not going to use it and talk about it for 20 seconds. We're going to talk about it for a segment. We're going to invest in this topic and try to really make a change. And outside of her platform, just even having a nonprofit to say, okay, I've worked myself up. Now I can use that as another key point to make a difference. Let's dream big. Stop dreaming small. That's something that really irritates me. That's not big enough. We need to go bigger. And so I want to go big, think big, dream big. You're not big enough. So for me, I want to make sure that when you do come to that challenge, you come to that mountain, you're like, how am I going to cross it? There is someone that's there to say, like, actually, so crazy. God just sent me as a messenger. I'm gonna help you get past that. I have a passion for using my platform to help influence other girls that look like me and help them guide them through their journey and let them know like, hey, there's another girl that's been through what you've been through. She's doing what you've done. I've learned this lesson. Hopefully I can help you learn it early so you ain't gotta do what I went through. I love working with Black talent. I love being a Black producer. I love being able to put together my own show and say like, this is the insight. This is what is important. This is the message that people need to hear about today. So for me, it's just about like speaking on issues that matter and being the behind the scenes voice that people don't even know about. But at the end of the day, like making a difference in the world. When it comes to those local stories where I'm like, we actually just got the city leaders to literally file a lawsuit against these owners. Like those are that's the change you wanna see. That's the power that the media has. So it's like when they are reaching out and there are people in the community who are saying, hey, I'm dealing with this issue right now. I'm having a problem right now. And we have the platform to take it to the next level. To me, especially being Black and seeing that change in the Black community is like so powerful. Everybody has this like culture understanding and everybody has that cultural passion for the story. Even if it's bad news, good news, social injustice, anything like that, everybody has this love for it and this funness that they bring to it, and I'm happy to be a part of it. I'm very passionate about just the community that we have and being able to have that community here at WLWT and being able to say, I'm a part of it. And I'm a part of if another, you know, Black face comes walking through here, I'm part of the welcome committee of, hey, let's talk, let's chat, let's see what's going on. And everybody welcomed me the same way.